I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you, So What's Up.
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So What's Up. Okay, let's go, let's go. One of the hardest, and see how I started just scrunching my face up, because you gotta do that when you mention them. And rest in peace to Guru of Gangstar. He said they're like Run DMC on steroids. So you know that's a lot of bulking up right there. Man, this one is about the legend, or like they call themselves, the world famous M.O.P. The song, and it's where they're from. Brownsville, okay? Dig this. This one right here is a little different because the first time I ever got to work with M.O.P. was in 1992, going into 93, when we met, because I used to be on WBLS doing radio. And when I heard How About Some Hardcore, shout to DR Period, one of the dopest producers out there in the game. I was just blown away by his production, and we didn't know who they were. When it came to the first album, To The Death, which was entirely produced by DR Period, we were just instant fans, and we got to see them live, and they sound just like the record. And all you saw was just black army jackets, gold teeth, and just a look of people that you just don't want to cross. And not only that, they're just is raw and they rhyming. Shout to Billy Danzini, aka Bill Dance, aka William Berkowitz. Shout to Lil Fang, aka Fizzy Womack, aka Rap Dude. There's a lot of AKAs. And shout to Tef, aka Teflon of M.O.P. as well. Shout to Fox from M.O.P., one of the hardest females in the world. She's from the Bronx, but everybody else from Brownsville. Lays, Boo Bang, even we're M.O.P. members, but we're not from Brownsville. Brownsville is, like they said, never ran, never will. First of all, they were on their second album, their sophomore album called Firing Squad. All right, we had become friends, and they were in the video for Code of the Streets. Shout to Ralph McDaniels and the Vid Kid, aka Lionel Martin, who were the ones that shot this video for us for Gangstar. Now we built such a rapport with each other that not only did we tour together, it was actually Nas, M.O.P., J. Rue the Damager, and Gangstar as a headliner. It was a dope tour. Nas was only on it briefly, but if you look at the old laminates of our backstage passes, it has all of us on there and our logos. So now, jumping back into this Brownsville song. I've always been into these weird space sounds. Shout to Pharrell. I just saw him do an interview with Mark Ronson, and I saw him talk about how he comes from the era of Star Trek, and he's always been into space sounds and whatnot. I'm not a Trekkie, but, you know, it's part of my childhood coming up. But sound-wise, I like to just experiment with things so that I can show that the versatility of a producer is not just in one box. You know, be in several boxes and still keep your funk there when you lay things down. When it comes to M.O.P., I'm only going one way, and that's raw and uncut and hardcore. So I was going through sounds and looking for stuff, and I just heard these funny little, almost like communication sounds going blip, 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 blip. Just my ear, and again, I always put it back to the DJ ear. I was like, man, if I could take those little blip, 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 almost kind of like the way I did Come Clean, but not in the same way where it's biting, because we don't bite. Biting is a law in hip hop, for those that don't know, that if you bite, usually it'd be an ass kicking or a fight. Over just sounded like somebody else. I come from that era. I mean, even in the club, somebody go, yo, you bit my shit. Boom, a fight jump off. B-Boys Breakers, yo, you bit my move. Fight break out. So I was not gonna have it sound nowhere near what J. Rue's Come Clean sounds like, but I could hear just a different type of approach. Here's where the problem lied. I'm an Akai MPC 60 user at that time, and I was using an Akai S950 or S900 at that time, 93, yeah. I was graduating to the 950. This is the problem. When I went to the session where, and shot the Lazy Lays, where they booked it, they didn't have an MPC 60 or 950. They ordered the wrong equipment that I asked for. I don't mean M.O.P. Lays. They had an MPC 3000. You sample into that. My version, I don't sample into. I trigger it with the 950. Being that neither one of those were available, I don't know how to put the sounds into the 3000. So of course there was some frustration, I'm complaining, and Laze is very technical, understands how to program beats and whatnot. So Laze was like, how about you feed the sample of those sounds, the bloop, 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 bloop. I'll show you how to assign it on the pads the way you want, and then you program it how you want, and then we'll dump it to tape, 2-inch tape, which is how we were recording our songs. This is the reason why you don't see MPC 60 written on here, because it was saved on an MPC 3000. Once Laze gave me the assignments to the pads the way I like to do it, he said, it's pretty much the same type of formula of programming, get your program on, and there I did. Being that this one was programmed and saved on MPC 3000, we happen to have one here. Shout to Parks, thank you for making sure that there's one available, because not everybody has a 3000 anymore, because a lot of producers that I respect, even Lil Fame is one of the dopest producers and beat makers. They're into the MPC 2000 or the 2000XL, Marco Polo 2000 or 2000XL. A lot of people use the 2000. One of the key voices in their crew, his name is OG Boo Bang, wild dude from Brownsville. Now, OG Boo Bang had just passed away. So when we did the song, I said, I want the intro to have his voice, because at the end of How About Some Hardcore, he goes, I want to say what's up to the whole motherfucking MOP, boy. And I said, that's how I'm going to start the song. So at the beginning, I fly it in and kind of wait until that beat dropped with the little trickle down sound. Once the beat dropped, it was time for Bill and Fame to do their thing. But that was a salute to Boo Bang. We miss you, brother. And, you know, you live forever in all those MOP records, and Brownsville loves you, you know what I'm saying? So just wanted to make sure I put that in there. With this one, we're gonna take the MPC 3000, and this one is just load up the actual program, and when you hit play, it goes a little something like this.
I wanna say what's up to the whole motherfucking MOP, what?
First of all, when it comes to ad-libs, MOP is one of the kings of doing ad-libs. Even to watch them do it, they'll be whispering and going, okay, that, and I'm sitting there like, wow, look at them. Keep in mind, there were two or three other songs that I also did on that album, which required a 3000 as well. But after that, we were right back to the good old MPC 60 and the good old S950 and back to my formula. But when it comes to any equipment, it doesn't matter what you use. If your ear and your style is already set in stone of how you want to be representing what you stand for as a producer or a beat maker, you got to know that you can do it on any type of equipment. These are just my weapons of choice. Some people like 380, some people like AKs, some people like 45s, and some people like deuce deuces. All right? Pew, pew. Anyway, at the end of the day, y'all know what it is. We salute the floppy disk. All right? That's what's up.